Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about the second part of marketing macro environment. I have already explained the demographic and the economic forces in another video. So in this video, we will be discussing about the rest of the forces of the macro environment of marketing. This is a small introduction about me for you to understand who I am. My area of specialization in teaching and research, marketing, accounting and financial management. To watch more useful videos on accounting and marketing subjects, if you like my videos, you can give a like and do subscribing my channel as well. Let's have a look at, you know, the picture which represents the actors and forces what a company could identify in its micro and macro environment. Since we have clearly discussed about the micro environment in the other video, let us look at the forces that a company could identify in its macro environment. Among the forces, as we have completed our discussion on demographic and economic forces, we will be discussing about the rest of the forces in this video. The first force which we are going to discuss in the video is natural environment. Obviously, natural resources are needed as inputs by the companies and marketers. And the same resources could also be affected by the marketing activities as well. Increased pollution is a matter of concern with regard to natural environment. Yes, companies are through their acts and, you know, rules and regulations brought out by the governments at different level to control pollution. The pollution which comes out of the production plant or other aspects of the company, it really affects the natural environment. It also eventually affects the interest of the company as well. The shortage of raw materials. Many companies depend upon the raw materials which are natural resources. When they depend upon the natural resources, if they are scarce resource, I am sure your production methodology has to be changed in the days to come. Because one time, definitely in the future, it is going to be nil of the raw materials you depend upon currently. So you have to find out the alternative ways or the alternate for the natural resources which are used in your production. Then increase the government intervention to protect the planet, the natural environment. Obviously, government comes out with the environmental, you know, pollution control act and so many related, you know, acts and regulations which are to be strictly followed by your consent if you want your consent to run successfully without any legal disputes. Now, many of the corporates, not only in India, throughout the world, they have realized their responsibility to protect their environment. Because they feel they are also part of the environment. And out of this interest, many companies have come out with supporting of environmental sustainability. They have come out with a lot of programs to protect the planet. They avoid the materials or the inputs which go to damage the planet. In fact, I have written an article titled, Take Care of the Three P's That Will Take Care of Your Business. It is available in ResearchGate. You can browse. What are the three P's I have discussed in detail in the article? Number one is the people in and around your organization, your employees, the people who are working with you and the people you are targeting upon for your marketing offer, and also the people in the society. That's what the meaning of people I have referred. And the second P stands for planet. It is a responsibility of every corporate, you know, citizen and, you know, individuals to take some initiative to protect the planet. Because it is a beautiful environment which we are going to leave as the biggest gift or wealth to our next generation. That we have to realize. It's not only the individuals, the company should also understand the fact. So many companies have come out with initiative to protect the environment. So they have come out with the environment friendly activities. So it is an effort to create a world economy that the planet can support indefinitely. This is what about the idea behind environmental sustainability. Hence, the companies are responding to consumer demands with more environmentally responsible products, and they have started manufacturing eco-friendly environment, eco-friendly products, and that's what about the idea I'm sharing with you. And the next one is about the technological environment. The technological environment is perhaps the most dramatic force now shaping our destiny. The changes taken place in the technological environment that has got a greater impact in all industries, in all sort of businesses, even in our day-to-day lives. As individuals, we realize the importance of changes in the technological environment. New technologies create new markets and opportunities as well. However, every new technology replaces an older technology. This is what we have to understand. See, I remember a pager which was given birth in the telecommunication market. It replaced to a greater extent the telephone or writing letters. Then the birth of mobile phone, it completely replaced the pages. In fact, the lifespan of pager technology was very, very short. It's because of the entry of a better replacement into the market for pager, which is nothing but mobile phone communication. And that, we have to understand. So this is one example of, the impact of new technology. It consists of forces that create new technologies, creating new products, and creating a lot of opportunities. No company should look at the changes as a challenge. It could be a challenge for you to bring out new products. That is how you can look at it. You understand, right? And you should not look at it as a disturbance. Get along with the technological advancements and make your company, your employees to grow. This is what, expected of every corporate citizen. The forces from technological environment change the way the company should operate themselves. With regard to production, you cannot do production the way you were doing, in the past. You have to replace the machinery. Now robots are introduced in the factory. If there is a necessity for you to definitely replace, all this with modern technologies to improve your production, to improve the quality of your production, you should not hesitate. And moreover, when your competitors are, really picking up the latest technology, right, in their production, the way they do marketing, the way they do accounting, you should also go for it. Otherwise, you will be left behind in terms of growth and you will be isolated in the market. You cannot really live out of past glory. Continue to improve yourself. And that's what Stephen Covey, very rightly said. Believe in continuous improvement. This is very important. If you want to be number one, if you want to be successful continuously, and try to believe in continuous improvement and better your best always. And that is what about the lesson every marketer should learn from the technological environment. See, just in time production, purchasing, instead of accumulating the raw material, and you buy everything at one time and accumulate them and dump a huge amount of capital, working capital on the inventory, this could be avoided, nowadays. It's because of the penetration of technical advancements. You can go for electronic data processing, EDP. You can, exchange your required data with other business counterparts, with your suppliers, right, with your consumers. They can come to know whether, the product you want to buy is in stock with you or not. It's that you try to understand, by accessing Amazon, all these, retailing websites. And they clearly let you know whether a particular brand you want to buy is in stock or out of stock, and how many more units are available with them. So this is what about the idea, Then the SAP, auditing, taxation, the way you do taxation, it's all changing, The government is also updating MCA, the Minister of Corporate Affairs has changed the way the companies could be registered, right? Now it's all online, you know, application, you know, you need to submit. It's not like the past. Research and development, making use of technology, you can do better research and development nowadays in any field, and that should be understood and picked up by your company as a successful concern. And the next one is about political and social environment, a very important one. It is concerned with the laws, government agencies and pressure groups that influence and limit various organizations and individuals in a given society. And their pressure is, you know, something which you cannot ignore, and they can really shape the way you could do business. What you could produce, what you could not produce, they can decide very well. You know, that is the power of this political environment. Then legal legislation regulating business, increasing legislation, changing government agency enforcement, new forms of non-tariff barriers, right? And the procedure to be followed to get your business registered, or what are the formalities to be fulfilled by a foreign company to come into another country, what sort of formalities to be fulfilled for registration, for locating their business, to get the license, so many other affairs. Right? These are all the forces that come from the political, you know, environment. And the next one is about, you know, the social environment. Yes, increase the emphasis on ethics and socially responsible actions. That you can evidence, you know, with many corporate citizens nowadays. They volunteer themselves to behave socially responsible. And they also involve in cost-related marketing. Good examples over here, Procter & Gamble's Beyond the Dreams project, HUL's Washing Hands project, you know, which I have explained in other video. Then the ITC, you know, through its stationeries, you know, in the brand name Classmate. And it has come out with the educational support to the poor. Then Tata has initiated programs related to green marketing. Then if you speak about the latest one, you know, and now the people who are suffering out of cardiac and, you know, diabetes problems, right? Now, due to the poor financial shape of the family, and they find it very difficult to buy the medicines which are a bit costlier, recommended by their doctors. Now, Blue Cross Laboratories has come out with an initiative. Through that initiative, it has made an appeal to the doctors and the patients that it is able to offer those medicines or equivalent medicines at a price which is 60% lesser than that of the price of the normal medicines being consumed by the patients. So they can opt for the medicines, you know, supplied by Blue Cross, you know, laboratories. What about, you know, and the initiative and taken place during the COVID-19 pandemic. And the next one is about cultural environment. It's a very beautiful definition for culture. You know, I like it the most, which I picked up from an international marketing. So an anthropologist, a very popular anthropologist, G. Hofstede, he has defined the term culture. Culture, according to him, the collective programming of the mind that distinguishes the members of one group or category of people from others. Or it is a set of beliefs and values developed by one group of people that are transmitted to the next generation, which are being followed by the next generation as they are, without questioning them. Now in India, many of us, we believe that Wednesday is a good day. What is the scientific proof for saying that it is a good day? And they come out with so many proverbs and all, you know, in different culture. But what is the proof? There is no proof for it. But still people believe it without questioning the fact about it. So this is what about, so it is a set of beliefs, you know, collective programming of the mind of one group of people, which distinguishes one group of people or the members of one group from that of other group. That's what about the fantastic meaning of culture. Cultural factors strongly affect how people think, how people, how they consume, what they should buy, what they should not buy, how they should dress, how they should behave, how to deal with others, what should be their approach in the society. Quite a lot are the food habits, everything. And perhaps the meaning of want in marketing is what? It's a need which is shaped by, it's a form of a need shaped by culture and personality of the people. So culture is an aspect a particular marketer is not affordable to, you know, ignore. It is very important, cannot be ignored by a marketer. So marketers are keenly interested in the cultural environment of their consumer market. This environment is made up of institutions and other forces that affect society's basic values, perceptions of people towards something. The same scenario could be perceived by two people from two different environments. It's because of the cultural impact. They try to define a particular situation referring their own culture. This is what cultural syndrome. An American, if he looks at the Indian, you know, Indians, from the perspective of American, this is what a syndrome, cultural syndrome. He wants to define Indian culture in American perspective. That should be avoided when you want to go to other countries for marketing your products. And come try to adapt to the situations. You don't have to appreciate, you know, the conditions in other countries, but you know, you need to accept. You need to accept what is happening. Understand, you know, why they are doing this way. And this is what very important for a company to be successful. You know, understanding the cultural norms of the, you know, consumers. If the culture varies, you know, widely from country to country, that, you know, you have to understand. People grow up in a particular society that shapes their basic beliefs and values. There are two kinds of beliefs among people. One, core beliefs, and the second one is a secondary belief. Core beliefs that are, and core beliefs and values are passed on from parents to children and are reinforced by schools, churches, business, and government. Whereas if you look at, you know, secondary beliefs, and values, they are more open for change. Obviously, I would suggest, though this point, you know, and says this way, I would suggest that companies or marketers should not make an attempt to change the core beliefs of people of a society. It is very tough. And it should be spontaneous. It should, you know, come automatically, then only you can pick up. You don't make any attempt to really change the core beliefs and values of people. Whereas, you can make quite a lot of attempts, you know, and to have a change in the secondary values and beliefs of the people. And that is what, you know, is happening with regard to the cosmetics, you know, market, you know, then furniture market, then the garments industry and all that. The major cultural values of a society are expressed in people's view. Here you have to understand, what is the view of the people of a society in your product market? They might belong to any one of these categories. You have to understand. People vary in their emphasis on serving themselves versus serving others. It depends upon the type of society to which they belong. Whether they belong to individualistic society or collectivist society. If they belong to individualist society, I am sure, and they will serve themselves in a better way than that of, you know, the way they serve others. Whereas in collective society, they treat both equally. They want to serve others also the way they do, they serve themselves. Recently, observers have noted a shift from a me society to we society because of the situation where you find people are very badly affected due to natural calamities, you know, and all this stuff. During such a critical juncture, many people tend to realize what is the use of having this much wealth. We are unable to buy whatever we want to consume. What is the use of this money? Let us all join together in the society. So this is the feeling. And what is the type of society your consumers belong to? If they belong to the second one, you have to act accordingly. The third one, people vary in their attitudes towards corporations, government agencies, trade unions, universities, and other organizations. See, by and large, many people in the society are willing to work for major organizations And in turn, they want such organizations to do their might for the society, for the well-being of the people in the society. People vary in their attitudes towards the society. See, there is nothing static. Please try to understand this particular point. And the attitude or beliefs of the people might change. Might change. Definitely, it is possible. So you have to keep watching. What is the change, you know, in their perception, in their beliefs and attitudes towards society, towards others, towards themselves, that's one. People vary in their attitudes towards the natural world. Now, we tend to give more importance to the nature. Why? There is a shortfall in rain. We are unable to, you know, predict things. Quite a lot of, you know, and the tragedies are taking place due to the natural calamities. So now we tend to believe or give importance to the nature. Understand pollution. This is another problem. Global warming. Quite a lot of issues are, new terms are coming for new problems and issues. Right? So that is why we move towards nature now. Right? Then people vary in their beliefs about the origin of the universe and their place in it. This is about mostly, in a way, it depends upon, you know, the religion, the religious beliefs and values, you know, the consumers follow. And before, you know, I thank you for watching this video. The conclusion I could say, how companies should respond to all these forces from the macro environment, they could be either reactive or proactive. But I wish the companies are being proactive in, you know, and predicting the likely changes that are going to be taken place or the likely influence of all these forces from the macro environment or the activities of the company. And, you know, you act before it happens. And that's what, you know, my recommendation. So with that, let me wind up this video. Thanks for watching this video. If you find this video very useful and interesting to you, you give a like and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.